Good evening and welcome to another episode of the NAACP Chicago Westside Branch. I'm your host, Tara Levy, and we have a lovely guest tonight, the one and only Shay Mayweather. This young lady is doing incredible work here in the city of Chicago, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about her. Ms. Shay Mayweather is the founder and executive director of Yes, Queen! Young Adults Advocating Self-Confidence. And she's currently enrolled at Robert Morrow University and is set to graduate in 2019. So that's next year. Congratulations already, Ms. Mayweather. So can you tell us a little bit about Yes, Queen?
I love it. Well, one, that's like a saying that's part of my vocabulary way too much. But we plan to partner young girls of color in alternative education schools with financial mentors and tutors to help them advance financially, to get them to start thinking about career readiness and college readiness. It's something that I have been dedicated to for about 2 years now as I was in alternative education. So it was a no-brainer to know that I wanted to go back in and give back to the system that kind of gave me my second chance. It did my 180 for me. So.
Beautiful.
Super excited about it.
Beautiful. And I thank you for doing this because it's definitely needed here in Chicago.
Yes.
And a lot of places in inner cities as well. But the reason why we have Ms. Mayweather on the show today is because our theme for today, our show topic, is Sankofa. Sankofa is not just where we're located on NAACP's Westside Branch location, but it's also a great meaning. Sankofa. It means that there is no shame in going back to fetch what you have left behind or to return and correct a mistake. Learning from the past always allows you to plan ahead for the future and to take better actions. So for our theme for this show is looking back from the past to correct mistakes as well as continue to build and grow for a better future. One of my favorite artists, she's super talented, and of course she's not nearly as famous as she should be, but she's still a dope artist. NDIRE speaks on this notion of looking back, talking to people to gain a better group of people, and it's called Better People, so check it out.
There was a video game to teach you your ancestor name. I wish there was a phone number like 1-800-SAVE-YOUR-BROTHER. Thankful for the radio station, not afraid to put the truth in rotation. There is certain information that you can only get in conversation with young people. But talk to old people, it would make a shot. All around, yes, boy. And if old people would talk to young people, it would make us a better people. All around, as it would. We went from radio to TV. Now we're going from LP to CD. Don't be afraid to try something new. Help you with the brand new technology. Oh. Help me with the age old philosophy. Oh. Together, there's so much we can do. Ooh.
We're young people.
We'll talk to
old people.
Yeah, we'll make a song.
Better people
all around. Yes, but if
old people
would talk to
young people.
You would make us a better
people.
They say every generation gets worse. Call it a generational curse. But these problems don't just drop off the sky. Yeah. Listen to my heart, my God, these words. Be the change you wanna see in the world. Start with yourself, man. local niggas should be bad people all around. Yes, but
again, that was Better People by the oh so talented and just well thought out NDIRE. There's one thing that she mentioned that Mahatma Gandhi also mentioned is be the change that you want to see.
Amen.
And again, that connects to Sankofa. You're looking back from the past to create a better present and a better future. That ties in with Yas Queen as well, because you went through some challenges as a young adult, mm-hmm. well, coming into a young adulthood. And like, because you went through those challenges, you want to make sure that the up and coming generation are better equipped, better prepared. Can you speak more about your program and where you see it going?
Yeah, so like I stated, I am part of the alternative education system and the public system, the public education system as well. And with alternative education, I was fortunate to have people to fight for me within that system, but I know that's definitely not the case, especially in Chicago that has a umpt amount of numbers of alternative education schools as well as Boston. But I see for the future for Yes Queen, I want to attack as many schools possible because I know what I needed back then that those girls need the exact thing now. And if I didn't have someone building my confidence or giving me exactly what I needed to hear mm-hmm. versus what they think I need, mm-hmm. I wouldn't be in this situation that I am. It took a lot. You know, mm-hmm. and it wasn't even like taking a lot when you say, oh, you got to fight through school. It was like taking a lot to even think I had a chance to even fight through school. So mm-hmm. battling that, I know what those girls are feeling. So I have to build that confidence. And sorry, girl, getting emotional.
Yeah.
I just have to build that confidence with the girls in there. And of course, I want to see my girls succeed, especially young women of color. Like,
absolutely.
We need to know how financial works. How financially that works, because we advance mm-hmm. through finance mm-hmm. as much as we don't want to, we do, and that's the way of the world, and we don't mm-hmm. get that education. I didn't have that education. I sold my soul for a bag of M&Ms for a credit card, so it's just mm-hmm. like, and it's something I'm still learning about.
Mm-hmm.
So I see this going past their college years. I want them to be set up for the future.
Yeah. And a few weeks ago, we talked about dismantling the school-to-prison pipeline. And I really believe that that starts with just having that mentor, that teacher, mm-hmm. that influencer in a young person's face to say, like, you know, you can make it. Mm-hmm. And you can't overcome what's happening to you right now. A lot of our kids go through traumatic situations on a day-in, day-out basis. And, like, they never get that proper treatment that they need to cope with that.
They don't even believe they have a chance.
Mm-hmm.
They don't even believe they're worth being successful. So it's like you can tell 1,000 people like, oh, you need to put funding in the schools. You need to do this. You need to do that. You can still have all of that and then yet have nothing if you don't believe in yourself. Like,
right.
I didn't believe in myself. And even though others, my mother, people that was around me believed in me, I didn't have that confidence because of my environment. Like, I just thought I wasn't even worth having a chance. So it's just like reshaping that language as well before you can even throw in money. Like, how are our kids gonna know that they can have all these resources, but they also have to have the confidence to go after it as well and
absolutely.
To go through it. So
absolutely. So this is why mm-hmm. having great educators matter, having a strong support system. Mm-hmm. It doesn't even have to be familial. Like, we look to family to be that support, but sometimes it's not always present.
Right.
And so our young people who are in the streets may turn to, like, gangs just because they have that support system. So an alternative to that would be providing a positive influence in our kids' lives, whether that be through school, after-school programming, other organizations, any way we can to look back from our past to see what mistakes that we wish we could have corrected and to teach the young people about that. Speaking of resources, we've highlighted a few for tonight's show. So, opportunities like Job Corps, That's a great organization where young people can build skills required to go out into the workforce. And you also said that your mom was
both parents.
Both your parents. Mm-hmm.
Both of my parents were part of, that's actually where they met. It was definitely, they got out from different places, both in situations where the environment wasn't that well. And so they didn't felt like they couldn't get through the public system. So they actually left both their senior years and met in Ohio at Job Corps. But it's an opportunity, it's a second chance mm-hmm. that was provided to them. Not only are you getting your degree, your high school diploma, but you're also learning trades.
Right.
And some of those trades that my mom learned, they weren't even quote unquote made for women. So it's just like they're, mm-hmm. I love Job Corps. I mean, it gave me my parents and it's definitely a very great program, an alternative program. And
Absolutely. And I know like a lot of schools, I teach at one of them. They push, have that college degree, college readiness, have that college degree for your institutions. And that's great. I believe that children of color, black people especially, we should get our education. We should go off to four universities, get our degrees, and be competitive in the job market right now.
However, how do you do that?
Mm-hmm. And is that the only way to be successful?
Right.
Is that what you measure to be, oh, I made it? So I think Job Corps allows you to have alternatives to that. Like, okay, maybe you're not going to college right after high school. And that's okay because you have a plan A or a plan B. You know, so find out what it takes for you to build your own success versus always having something else being dictated towards you mm-hmm. about what success is. Other opportunities. St. Leonard's. You mentioned that as well.
Mm-hmm.
St. Leonard's Ministry. You want to speak more on about that?
Yes. Yeah, so St. Leonard's Ministry provides second chances to formerly incarcerated men and women. I had the honor of working there for a year, and it's just a phenomenal program. Obviously, we don't want it to be several programs like it, but it's kind of that second chance. And it provides different skills that's open to the community as well. Two different trades that they focus on mm-hmm. is culinary and construction. And the reason why they focus on those two the most is because people with a background, meaning like a criminal record, they can get a job in that field versus another field outside mm-hmm. of that faster. So they provide that. It's a 10-week course for both culinary and the construction. Construction, you get your OSHA certificate.
Mm-hmm.
And then the culinary, you get your food safe serving certificate. I think I said that right.
Yeah.
And we also provide a high school that's open to the community as well, as long as you have a background. It is an intense 14 weeks, but it is accredited high school, and you can go and take that diploma to any college in Illinois. So mm-hmm. it's a great program.
A lot of opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
I would even say build on. That's it. Located in mm-hmm. Michelle Clark. Growing up, when people were told, like, oh, well, you know, so-and-so goes to Michelle Clark, it was like, oh, they're going to that school? Michelle Clark? Michelle Clark has done so many great things these past few years. And, like, now it's like, oh, they go to Michelle Clark.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's like, oh, they're doing great things over there. They have Build On. Build On is an organization geared to helping kids in the community. Like, they're part of that, looking back to see what our issues were and making sure that we're going to, like, restore that. Great organization as well. Chicago Park District has both volunteer and employment opportunities. I know they're always looking out for young people and people who are higher up in management as well to get some experience and help out. One program I participated in was Public Allies. Public Allies, it's an AmeriCorps program. You do a year of service at a nonprofit organization throughout the city of Chicago. And while it may be hard to live on that stipend life, you really get the taste of doing community organizing work and working with children and mentoring programs through CPS. So it's a lot of great opportunities present in Public Allies. And they also have opportunities for people who have backgrounds, as long as it's like you can see that they're making changes and making strides to restore their life, turn life around, they're open to accepting people with backgrounds as well. So there are a lot of great organizations that are out there. We want to make sure that you're knowledgeable of these orgs and that you you have the opportunity to apply or at least share if you know of young people who could benefit from it.
Bam. Wow.
Bam. Becoming a man. Unfortunately, a lot of our black young men who are growing up either with weak family ties or not availability to strong black fatherhood. So BAM is there to help our young men become men.
Yeah, BAM is there. They really have made a name for themselves as well. And then they're also associated with WOW that works with young women of color as well. So they're both connected. BAM is a phenomenal, phenomenal group. And they're really, really, I can't even speak enough about how great they are. But they teaches the young men like different skills of communication and how to properly, you know, talk to someone and provide them with that college readiness and tutor them and mentor them and then take them out in Chicago and show them things that they've never seen before. They're great. They bring in a lot of public speakers who come in and talk to the guys, and they're just a great group. I really appreciate them.
Absolutely. And the one organization I wish I was a part of, After School Matters, man, like, you get paid to do theater and dance and performances. Like, they are amazing. I've seen them perform at Navy Pier, downtown, all over the city. A couple of my students are in After School Matters. So many great opportunities for kids in high school. Take advantage of them. If only I knew about it, I would definitely have been a part of it, you know. Man.
What is the big show that they put on with the spoken word?
I think Chance partners with that. It's like open mic. What? I'm not sure if that's After School Matters or if that's through his organization, Social Works, which is another great nonprofit. Yeah. So, again, a lot of arts and culture in the city. Chicago is just so great with art and culture.
Yes, they are.
Like, it's amazing. We want to make sure that we know about this. We'd be the first to jump in on these opportunities because we need to know. Again, our theme. Sankofa, there's no shame in going back to fetch what you left behind.
Amen.
So learning from your past. We all make mistakes. We all have things that we're not so proud of. But how can we grow from that? How can we become better? Learning from the past allows you to plan well for the future and to take better actions. What are your thoughts on that?
I'm a living, breathing that person. So how I ended up in alternative education and how most students end up in alternative education is you end up getting in trouble, and that's what happened with me. So when I was expelled my junior year, I was sent to safe school, and I was just, it was such a different route that you just didn't know. So now, like, thinking back of who I am right now, it's just like, how did I get to this point? How was I able to start Yes Queen? Where did that motivation come from? And I had to look back and see how much my life has changed, what I've done, and just continue growing. But if I didn't look back at the past, how would I know what not to do?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Thank you for sharing. Yeah. Thank you so much for sharing. We have a caller.
Good evening, ladies.
Good evening. How are you?
Happy holiday. This is Auntie Paula calling.
Auntie Paula. We remember you, Auntie Paula.
You both look beautiful on TV tonight. Yes,
oh,
you do.
Oh, thank you.
I like that India singing that song at the beginning.
Yes, it's so good.
Beautiful. That's all beautiful. All women of colors, all colors, the whole wide world. And I'm so proud of you ladies sitting next to, I don't know your name, the guest for the evening, but your mama and daddy must have taught you right. You must have had a mentor ever since you was a little girl. Might I be right?
My mom, she's recording me right now.
So you got lucky. Now looky here, I'm a person that didn't have a mother or father. They passed away when I was younger, and I was raised by my aunt, but she did the best she could. I grew up the best I could. I learned my P's and Q's. I did not finish high school, which was the biggest mistake of my life, but I did go into the food industry. And I, throughout the years, almost 40 years I've been in the food industry, we see all kinds of people coming in there, being waiters, being busboys, being bartenders.
I use a bartender,
yeah. I find that the young African African-American ones that come in, first of all, they hook up to Auntie Paula because I know how to waitress, I know how to bring the soup, the salad, all this and that, but they got a personality when they come to a table of a gentleman, and people just absolutely absorb them. I don't know how many kids that I worked with in my restaurant, so that's just an idea. It's not the best job in the world, but if you're a young kid, and these kids are 16, 17 years old, they weren't even allowed to serve alcohol, so if we had to bring a beer to the table, us older people would, but that's a good job to get yourself started in. I mean, the jobs today, the kids today in Chicago are batting 1,000. These school teachers are marching so much, the kid don't know when to go to school, when he's off for 3 days. They can't seem to get it together with these teachers. Give them the money. The money is there. Give it to the teacher that's teaching 40 kids at one classroom, whether it's a Catholic school, a public school, a polka-dotted school. Give the teachers the money. Okay. They should have to be walking around freezing their little booties off to make it get themselves a raise. They deserve everything that they deserve, everything they got coming. They are teaching our youth. These kids today are batting 1,000. They don't know who the heck to listen to. Some kids got mommy and daddy. Some people got a mentor like you on TV. You two over there every week on CAN TV. The parents try to step up the best they can, and then they get knocked down with the Cook County strikes of the school teachers. Give them the money.
Thank you, Ms. Paula.
Give them their insurance. Give them whatever they got. You got to start. The kids want to go to school. They don't want to hang around on the corners with Leroy getting in trouble. They want to go to school. But then when they on strike, the school doors close.
Yes.
They ain't got no good water. They ain't got no...
Thank you, Ms. Paula, for calling. We were so happy to hear from you. We have another caller. Hello, caller.
Hi. So I just wanted to bring in, I heard you guys were talking about Sankofa.
Yes.
I'm going to derive my Cree language of Ghana, and you guys did a really great job at addressing it and bringing it up and just representing. I just want to also make sure that, just make a note of the bird, how it looks back and get the egg to, you know, rebirth the future, and I just appreciate you guys bringing it.
Can you repeat that last part, please? Okay, I think we lost our caller. Yeah, I think we lost him. But I think we were talking about Sankofa from what I could hear. Yes, I think what Ms. Paula had mentioned, that we have to look back again to see what's right, what's wrong, and how we can improve. So we thank you, callers. If you have any resources that you would like to share, like Ms. Paula shared how the food industry...
And people like
a great resource.
Kind of downgrade the food industry, but I bartended for 7 years, and that was easy money, and it was easy, but it also provides skills. Service industry gives you people skills. Mm-hmm. It gives you a way of like connecting with multiple different type of people on mm-hmm. different levels, and it's a networking opportunity. So, Ms. Paula, you don't even have to think that being in the service industry is anything bad, because it's not, because it taught me valuable skills. Like, I used to be a shy little thing, but then I have to be like, and what would you like to drink today with a personality?
mm-hmm.
And that turned into me bartending at multiple places, country clubs, nightclubs, ballparks. Like, food industry teaches you a lot. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Absolutely. My first job was at Goodman Theater. I was front of house staff. So I would be like the ones to sell you the cookies and the candy. Mm-hmm. I was 16. Again, still really quiet too, but it helped me to get out of my shell. So there's a lot of takeaway skills that you can have from there.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I definitely owe the service industry to being able to talk to people.
Because
mm-hmm. before that, I'm like...
See, and it's part about growth, too. I feel mm-hmm. like when you come into your own womanhood, when you come into your own self, you're able to be more confident and more comfortable with who you are. You're less, like, afraid to just make that light shine.
Yeah.
And it's okay to be quiet. I'm still a quiet person. You know, I just know that there's nothing wrong shining my light, too.
All right.
You know?
I see.
We have about 5 minutes left in our show. It's not too late to call in to share some resources that you know will be good to have out in our community, or as well just to chime in and let us know what you're thinking. You can call now at 312-738-1000. 1060. Before we wrap up, do you have any final words, Miss Mayweather? Any lasting thoughts?
Lasting thoughts. Man, I don't care what you've been through or where you come from. If you believe in yourself, and as very, very, like, what's the word?
Cliche
as it sounds.
It's for real.
Keep fighting. And if you got to wake up every day in the morning, which I do, go to the mirror and say, I am confident. And you walk out that door and be confident, and you attacked everything like you're living your last days. Mm-hmm. Because I swear, if you don't give up, you can make it. Mm-hmm. I'm making it. I'm trying.
Absolutely.
I'm trying.
Absolutely. And I want to say that words are so powerful. Words are so powerful. Mm-hmm. And you have no idea just how much weight it carries. Mm-hmm. I could say, oh, this is going to be hard for me. I can't do it. I'm going to give up. I already have a defeated attitude because I claimed it. Mm-hmm. Right? But if I say, you know what, this is a challenge for me, but I can overcome this.
Yeah, you're giving yourself a chance to be great. Mm-hmm. That's my last word. Give yourself a chance to
come
be great.
Come on, somebody. Yes, give yourself a chance to be great because we are great. Mm-hmm. We are here for a reason. I truly believe that all of us here on earth were sent here for a reason. If not, we wouldn't be here. So what is that reason that you're sent here? That may take years and years to find out. Like, I'm 25, and I'm still trying to figure out a little bit about my purpose. I see a glimpse. You know, I get little pictures of it. But you have to just have that confidence and know that you are great.
Find your purpose.
Find your purpose.
And
be you. And be you. There's only one you. There's only one you. Everyone else is taken. So be yourself. This has been a great show. The theme of Sankofa, the theme of self-love, the thing of being you. Our callers, we appreciate you. I appreciate you, Miss Mayweather, for coming in. It's been just a blessing to my heart, and it's a way just to kick off my weekend.
Yes. Happy Friday.
Happy Friday, y'all. Happy Friday. It's been a week.
Finals.
But we are here. We are great. We are big. Even if we're tired, we're still great. We still pull it off.
I got a 4.0.
Come on.
For that quarter.
Come on.
I was so happy. It took a lot.
See?
Oh, Lord.
but it's here. Push through, you all. I hope we have a blessed weekend. I hope that you took something from this show. Something spoke to you for those who watched. For those who called in, again, thank you. We appreciate you for tuning in another Friday with us. Have a wonderful weekend. And remember, we are the NAACP Chicago Westside Branch. Feel free to join us at 5820 West Chicago Avenue for our monthly meetings, the first Saturday of every month at 1 p.m. I am your host, Tara Levy, and have a great evening. Thank you.